everyone. Welcome to Bayas Nayad, We Are Not the Same. Happy Black History Month. Happy Chinese New Year. Happy Valentine's Day. Happy new month of February. I would like to start off by saying, rest in peace, Miss Cicely Tyson. You are what true Hollywood is. You've given us a chance of what our roots are by being such a pivotal actress in the movie Roots. And among many of your performances, you've showed us what true strength is. Miss Cicely Tyson, you are a legend. You will be missed, but not forgotten. Thank you for who you are. How many of you would like to pop and lock? How many of you would like to do that fabulous dance move that you've always dreamt of? Well, another one on this rock, proving that we are not the same. We have choreographer Shane Sparks.
What's good? How are you?
Good. I miss you. I haven't seen you in forever. What's going on?
I know, man. It's like the world just condemned me. No, I'm playing. Well, I was in Los Angeles forever. You know what I mean? And I moved to Las Vegas about 2 years ago.
Oh, wow.
So I kind of went like, I don't want to say undercover, but I just kind of went away from everybody and everything, just kind of reinventing, revamping, and just, you know, enhancing the skills that I have that nobody ever really knew that I had. So I've been out here doing videography, music, production, a lot of editing, you know, artist stuff, developing, and just a lot of stuff that I've been, you know, been doing. So I'm keeping pretty busy. And what's crazy is a lot of people that are not working, like the ones that were working before this happened aren't working. And the ones that wasn't working, they're working more because I don't have to be there to do it.
Isn't that crazy, Shane? I mean, yeah. I thought, you know, some of the people that have been working so much now would probably be, you know, either some of them are actually, you know, not working as much, but I thought that maybe they would be producing and doing so much more, but it seems like everything is at a standstill. Or, I mean, I could be mistaken. I mean, you just went straight into work, but I wanted you to talk about who you are so everybody knew who you were first.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's a trick question.
My name is Shane Sparks. I'm from Cincinnati, Ohio, originally. I got two sisters raised by my mama. But I moved to California. I did a TV show called So You Think You Could Dance, another show called America's Best Dance Crew. I choreographed the movie You Got Served. I choreographed Dreamgirls, the stage, the Broadway show. Toured the world with a company called The Pulse. I worked with almost any and everybody, MTV Movie Awards. I was Emmy nominated. I won BET Awards. I did a little bit of everything.
Goes, I know, I'm like, and the list goes on and on. Look, these are my dance moves, okay? Don't judge me, okay?
That's all good, it's all good.
Wow, Shane. No, but you know, you've had an extensive resume and you've done quite a bit for the world, if I must say so. Now, I know that, you know, one doesn't just come about becoming a choreographer. Right. What inspired you to become a choreographer?
Well, to be honest with you, when I came to California, in Cincinnati, we danced every weekend. We was like considered one of the best groups. There was a few other groups that was pretty dope, but we was considered one of the best. So when I came to LA, I didn't look at nobody as if they were better than me, but they treated you like they were better than you if they were the choreographers or if they were the producers or directors. And I would look at them and I would be like, I would murder you on the dance floor, but you got the power. Yeah. And I was like, I don't want to be judged by somebody that I feel like I'm better than. Not being arrogant, but there's a lot of people out there that are working for people that they were murder on the dance floor. Right. And that's just how the business is. But coming from me, I'm a battler. When you're a battler, you look at another dancer. As soon as you see them, you got your arms up. You're looking at them like, what's up? And it's not in a bad way. It's just like, let's see what the best is. So when I see a person dance and I know that I'm better than them, but yet they have the power, I can't take that. So I was thinking to myself, like, the only way I could be in that position and not be judged by people that aren't worthy of judging me is if I became the choreographer. So I stopped auditioning. I think only auditioned for like two or three different shows. Yeah. And that was when I went on tour with Immature, Quindin, and IMX back in the day, you know.
Uh-huh.
And I auditioned for a couple other things that I didn't get. And that's what made me say, yo, you'll never judge me for my dancing again. And I became a choreographer.
And that's how you became a Korean. You know, you said something that's key. You said you're a battler, you're a fighter. And I think a lot of people forget that our innate ability to fight can drive us so far. You know, but fight wisely and nicely. I think that's what you were
talking about. Yeah, definitely.
Yeah.
Definitely. Yeah. People don't understand. Like, there's this, you can fight, but you can fight from a good place.
That's
fight
right.
Fight
the good
fight. You know what I mean? You fight the good fight. You will always win. It might take you longer, but you will win eventually. I never came out here with an arrogant attitude. Everybody that I know that met me when I first moved to LA, if I talk to them right now, they'd be like, Shane, you're the same person. You'd have been around the world. You'd have done a million things.
I know.
At a Ford Escort, living in North Hollywood with no money. You're the same guy. Because the dance industry, the movie industry, it didn't make me. I was already Shane Sparks.
That's right. That's right.
You just got to know me.
Yes. Mm-hmm. No, the name is powerful. The name is powerful. I admire you. You know, I'm a fan and a friend. But the other thing that I think, I just listening to what you're saying and the encouragement that you're giving to everyone, what are the challenges and benefits, you know, in a world like yours? I think you've kind of told us a little bit, but it's a pretty big, you know, world, and it's very competitive.
Yeah, I'll say this, like I listen to, there's a lot of dancers that's new to the industry, and some of them are so amazing, it blows my mind. And they've been in here for a little bit, but they're just now starting to go through what I was going through when I was in the park, when I was at their level, you know what I mean? And I'll say names because I know these guys, they know that I'm coming from a good place, but there's a guy by the name of Fiction. I saw him, Fiction, yeah. So You Think You Could Dance, ABDC, he's sick. He was posting his emotions and his feelings about how other people were judging him and looking at him and talking about his style. And when I first watched it, I was like, I wanted to go grab him and hug him and be like, yo, Fiction, it's not real. It's not real. Uh-huh. I guarantee you the people that are talking about you right now in 2 years, 3 years, you won't even know them because you're on a different level.
Exactly.
They always talk about you when you're bigger than them. Pay attention. He needs to pay attention to that. Just listen. You will never see me on TV. You never see no interviews of me nowhere going off on nobody because I will watch it. I will listen. And then I will go and study You Think You Can Dance and do the coldest routine they ever seen in their life and shut them up. You feel me?
Ladies and gentlemen, we are not the same. You said it. They always talk about you when you're bigger than them.
Exactly. And once he realizes that, he won't even listen to what they're saying. He'll listen because a lot of times that's fire. A lot of that negativity, it fuels you and it makes you go do something amazing. But don't let nobody know it got to you. Only let them know it got to you by the next performance you do.
There you go. I love this. Oh my gosh. You know, we're at church, are we?
I'm not being negative. I'm just being real. And you need not just Fiction, but it's a lot of dancers at that age. He's a young dude. They need somebody around them that can help mold them into the businessman, the professional, the whatever they're going to be, because those little things that he's worried about be the things that destroy us.
That's right. That's so true.
You feel me? We end up doing something or saying something that we shouldn't have said or did based off our emotions for what somebody else did, and they don't even mean nothing.
They don't mean nothing.
And then they stop talking about you when you ain't on top no more. All of a sudden, your name ain't nowhere in their mouth when you're not on top no more because their job is done.
Wow. You know what I mean? Ladies and gentlemen, Beas Nahel, We Are Not the Same, a moving conversation with Shane Sparks. Shane, how has the pandemic affected you? How has
Well, I'm in Vegas. To be honest, Vegas is moving. Like Vegas, there's a few things that stopped, you know, for a minute, but then they pick back up. The only thing that I noticed around here is that we got to wear masks everywhere we go. But I don't mind that because once you get in, you can take it off, except for at the gym. When you get to the gym, you got to wear it the whole time. Okay. But other than that, I was just at the strip today. We just went down to Fremont and we was driving go-karts. You know what I mean? I'm living my best life right now, you know, and then I'm doing an interview with you and I'm editing a commercial right now, editing a dance video right now. It's just stuff just going on. I'm sitting back and I'm just being patient. You know what I mean? I haven't been this relaxed and secure in my life in the past 10 years. You know what I mean? Like right now, I feel good.
No, you know what? What I'm enjoying is your passion when you start talking about dance. And I know that you do the choreography, but then also if we want to tap into, you know, the creativity aspect of it, you can actually tell me, you know, what inspires you for certain kind of, you know, maybe dance choreography. And then also, what are, I guess, the elements that, you know, make you create a powerful choreography? Yeah.
Okay. Listen to this. Every dancer is going to relate to this. I don't care. I didn't say dancer, like every guy. Okay. You ever, you know who Bruce Lee is, right?
Of course I know who Bruce Lee is.
Bruce Lee, the guy, his master, I think I was watching Enter the Dragon the other day. His master, I noticed, but every time I hear it, I'm like, that's so sick. He says, what is your style? He said, my style is the style, the artist, the style.
Bruce Lee.
Without fighting. You know what I mean?
Say that again.
My style is fighting without fighting. Something like that. My style as a dancer is not, I can never put a style on me because I wasn't trained by a specific style. Mm-hmm. I watched, learned, practiced, trained, create, and I take from here. If I'm inspired by a dancer, all I have to do is see two moves or feel their energy and I can do their style like that. Because I wasn't trained as a popper, as a ticker, as a waver. I wasn't trained at that. I learned from the world. I was watching this stuff a long time ago when it was first coming up. And so I learned how to do certain things. So when it comes to me doing a certain style, it's the music. When I hear the music tells me what style of dance I need to do. You feel me? If it's a slow bass line, if it's a hard snare, if it's a high, if it's hi-hat driven, if it's a pretty chord, if the vocals are emotional, or if it's just a gritty song, as soon as I hear it, it's like a movie. When you watch a movie, you could tell if it's a drama, comedy, whatever. As soon as you hear it, you already know what you're about to get. So when I hear the music, it tells me where to go from a dancer's point of view. I'll do a lyrical number in a minute. I might not be clean with the turns and all this stuff. I'll let the lyrical dancers do that, but I can give them a lyrical routine with some emotion and some feeling behind it. I guarantee you that, because dance is just dance to me. It's just movement. You can put any name on it, any style, whatever you want to call it. At the end of the day, if you went to a world that didn't have no names on the dances, all they would say is they're dancing.
They're dancing. Exactly.
They're dancing.
With that said, we are actually in the beginning of our Black History Month. And I do want to acknowledge, you know, where I'm standing. I'm standing at Coquette Couture with all these colorful colors. But, you know, we have to tap into the roots and who I am and where I come from.
Right.
From the motherland, as we say. And when you combine the different styles of dance, you mentioned Bruce Lee. I know that in Asia, the dance movements are slightly different, or in Europe, they're different. But when you want to go back to the roots of, you know, African dancing, how particularly important is that in today's world of dancing?
That's a really, really good question. I will answer that the best way that I can without offending anybody.
Yes.
As a choreographer, I wasn't taught by the people who are the roots of some certain dances. So I can't go back to them.
I wanted to hear that. Yes.
All I say is do what you feel and do what your body tells you. And it just comes. And if there are sometimes when somebody will ask for a specific style, and then I will call up one of my friends that know that style in particular, and we'll get together and create something. I will do that. But I don't really go back nowhere to look, because what my body produces is what my body produces. And the only way you're going to get originality out of me is if I give you what I'm thinking and what I'm feeling at the moment you play your music. And then, like I said, if you want something specific, then I'll go out and resource. You know what I mean? But if you're saying you want Shane Sparks to come in and do a 30-minute dance performance like we did with Dreamgirls, like almost a 12-hour show. I gave them Shane Sparks with a little bit of hip hop, a little bit of R&B, a little bit of, you know, stage performance, a little bit of Dreamgirls, a little bit of Temptations. All the stuff that I'm around, I just put it in there. And if you ever get a chance to see the Dreamgirls show that I choreographed, you would be like, I don't even believe these people.